Very often I had the pleasure to speak with him about his experience in the world. He was a little bit everywhere. He was in South Africa, he was in Mexico, he was in China. And when every time I said to him, tell me, which are the differences? And that I found very, very interesting. So I invited him. He gave me the pleasure and the honor to come. He was old former manager Alfa Romeo in China a few years, and he will tell us his experience in China.
One word, the experience that I am talking about was not with Alfa Romeo, was with another company later on. Even I was already in China for Alfa Romeo in the 80s. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to tell you about my personal experience working in China during the years 2003-2005. At that time, I tasked with a startup of a company managed from an Italian head office. An index of the slide appearing to my commentary. See? Yeah. Good. Is at the present of the screen. The proceeding will follow the chronological order of the time I was in China. Both the slide and my presentation are in English, and please excuse my poor accent. Oh, we try to reply to a couple of questions. Why an European company decide to become established in China? The answer is well known, and the three reasons usually given are lower product cost, thanks to ready available workforce at competitive price, good availability of both raw and semi-processed material, desire to start and or expand activities on Chinese market and surrounding countries. The example of my company. The company manufactured pipes for cooling system for vehicles in Europe, mainly Italy, France and Poland. The custom included several of the major automotive European manufacturers. Clearly for my company, the main stimulus was the aim of increasing penetration in Chinese market as required by the client already operating there. In other words, the big European company was already there to produce, and they asked the supplier to go there to help them or to give the product locally. The media strategy was to shortlist certain regions in proximity of the future client. We started with a shortlist, including Shanghai, Dalian and Shenyang in the Liaoning province, in the northeast, Jilin province with the city of Changchun, and the Hubei province with the center of Wuhan. This was the first four areas where we think to go. To decide the location, we keep in consideration parameters or four factors. The first important consideration concern is communication and travel connection with Europe. Europe is a source of machinery, components, spare parts. In addition, particularly in the starting up phase, there will be frequent visits from European personnel. Second important point is the availability of areas to set up with services essential to good running of the business closer at hand. Because to go somewhere where it's so difficult to arrive, where there is no enough power installed, there is no, it's not easy. Even the cost is. I must point out that I was looking for a relatively limited total of cover surface between 1,500 and 2,500 square meters. I did not require large energy volume, and the companies we produced did not, in turn, produce any significant pollution. A total proposed investment over 2-3 years was estimated in $5 million American dollars, excluding the premises to be rent. A third important point is the availability of of low-cost labor and possibly specialized technician. In the case of my company, the requirement was approximately 100 workmen, both direct and indirect, as well as between 15 and 20 technical and administrative employees. The fourth point that I mentioned is the quality of life for the expatriates. Resident manager frequently with family, as well as technician on long-term placement, need to find some of the comfort and elements to which they are accustomed. It's not always enough to be lodged in the 4 or 5 star hotel. Is a fact, right or wrong, I don't know. It's a fact that when we are there after 6 months, we desire 3 months, we desire to have something of our original country, of our original habits. And I think the Chinese people in this room understood perfectly, because in my opinion also the Chinese like, even when they are abroad, to have something original from China, I think. So I started with a first mission, practically 2 months, October, November 2003. Hello, for me was my first visit in China. I was already in 1980 in Canton, at the time was the name, for a motor show, Alfa Romeo motor show. And in 1981, if I'm not wrong, I was part of a mission to several factories in Beijing, Shanghai, Shenyang, and Harbin. So I have already visited, but in 1981, as the China of 2004 was completely different. My third visit in China was more recent, in 2002, as an administrative management consultant to Fiat Auto in the joint venture in Nanjing. So I know already a little bit the new China, let me say, if I can say. Talking about the first contact, I had the objective when I went to China in October 2003 was to return to that office with all the information required to set up a fully functioning company, as well as all the license and authorization necessary to produce, sell in China, and export the pipes for cooling system, Once in China, I had some initial information from some friends and colleagues that they were working in Nanjing in 2002. For all these informal contacts, the advice was the same. Contact the development zone, which all provincial and municipal administration have established. It was easy to obtain web addresses from a business handbook, $5, that I bought in a shop. So from this information, I have a web address. From the web address, I went on. Believe me, everything by myself. No, I didn't need any special help, at least in this phase, any special introduction or something like that. The first contact was from Shanghai by telephone, despite some problem due to the out-of-date information from the web, as well as due to the language. I eventually managed to contact the right people in the various development zones. I always managed to find somebody who spoke and understandable English and willing to understand my English. That was not easy. While I fully expected the lack of interest due to the modest investments I was planning, that was not at all the case. In fact, everyone was prepared to listen and propose a very quick appointments. So the beginning was very good. Choice of the development zone. I don't, without wasting time on the decision process, I will concentrate it to Dalian and Shenyang, development zone. The other three zones, the other two zones, one in Changchun, was a little bit too decentrated, too far. Shanghai, which was already quite crowded, with relatively high local employment cost. Again, today, I don't know if my choice was correct, honestly. At that time, I went to Dalian and Changchun and forgot Shanghai. Maybe was more correct for some reasons that I will mention later on to make another decision. But this was the decision taken.